Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl.
The West Texas outpost of El Paso, a mining town with a heart of gold, and host of the second oldest college football game in the land. For 71 consecutive years, the legends of the game, coaches and players alike, have migrated to this desert frontier to carve out a little niche of football lore West Texans can call their own. The Purdue Boilermakers, with gunslinger Kyle Orton and his posse, have made El Paso a second home and look to end their season in a blaze of glory. The Sun Devils of Arizona State, quick on the draw, are taking dead aim at their finest season in nearly a decade. We welcome you to the Vitalis Sun Bowl from the West Texas town of El Paso. The Arizona State Sun Devils taking on the Purdue Boilermakers. There is simply no more appropriately named bowl in the country today than the Sun Bowl in El Paso. It is a glorious New Year's Eve afternoon. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Bert Lundquist, along with Todd Blackledge and Tracy Wolfson. Let us add our best wishes for a happy and prosperous new year to you all. A couple of relevant numbers as we get underway. This is the 71st Sun Bowl in El Paso. It is the first with Vitalis as a presenting sponsor, and we welcome them. It's the 37th consecutive year the game has been broadcast on CBS, and it is the first meeting ever between Purdue and Arizona State. If form holds, the air is going to be filled with footballs this afternoon, and Todd Blackledge, Purdue, particularly well-equipped with Kyle Orton and Taylor Stubblefield.
Yeah, you'd be hard-pressed to find a better pass-catch combination in college football over the last several years than these two guys. A couple of seniors, Kyle Orton from Altoona, Iowa, Taylor Stubblefield from Yakima, Washington. During their years at Purdue, they became very good friends off the field, and I think that has translated to great chemistry on the field. And I think it's more than just a little ironic that the best pass-catch combo that we can watch on NFL Sundays, Peyton Manning and Marvin Harrison, play right down the road from these guys in Indianapolis. And it's their chemistry, I think, that makes them special. They know where they're going to be, they have a great feel for each other, and they have been a lethal combination.
Purdue out of the Big Ten comes in with a 7-4 record. They won their first five. So also did Arizona State. But whereas Purdue does not have a question mark at quarterback, the same is not true for the Sun Devils.
Yeah, it's a little bit different for Arizona State as we take a look at the Argent Mortgage quarterback comparison. Andrew Walter, who was injured in the last game against Arizona, had a phenomenal year, became ASU's all-time career passing leader. Sam Keller came off the bench. The young sophomore played well in that game in a losing effort. And the good news for Sam Keller, even though this is his first start, he's had 15 days of practice to get ready for this bowl game, and he's got some good weapons, including an outstanding young tight end in Zach Miller. A year ago at this time, Zach Miller was considered the top tight end prospect out of Phoenix, Arizona. Flash forward to the end of this season, the Pac-10 Freshman of the Year, and he is a guy who can really make some things happen in the middle of the field for Arizona State.
You can see the folks who are gathered here in the sunshine in El Paso. It is a sellout this afternoon. First one in the 71 years of the Sun Bowl. 50,000 plus on hand as Arizona State and Purdue meet each other for the very first time. Arizona State, 10-5 all time against Big Ten teams. Purdue 9-17-3 all time against teams out of the Pac-10. The Purdue Boilermakers won the toss. They have deferred their option until the second half. That means that Arizona State will get the football to open the game. Ben Jones will kick off to begin the game. Rudy Burgess and Terry Richardson are the deep men. Richardson wears number 17 and Rudy Burgess number 3.
Getting up to game speed. Which team can get to game speed quickest? A big key in bowl games. After you've had a layoff, which team gets out to the early start, gets to game speed the quickest?
Here's Jones. That's a nice start. And so Sam Keller comes on the field for his first start ever. Told us yesterday he is really excited about this opportunity. He's out of Danville, California. for the season, 17 of 26, 236 yards. He came on in relief of the injured Andrew Walter and hit his first five passes in the loss at Arizona.
Yeah, he came in with just under 10 minutes, and his team was trailing 34 to 20 and actually played pretty well and almost brought him into a comeback victory.
That's Terry Richardson, who starts in motion, now comes back. They'll hand it off left side. Rudy Burgess, number three, who really is a wide receiver filling in a tailback, and tailback a problem issue for the Sun Devil football team. Let's check the lineups presented by the Hartford. Offensive line for the Sun Devils: Grayling Love, Stephen Berg, Hodgson, the fifth-year seniors, Zach Krula, and Andrew Carnahan. In the backfield, Rudy Burgess. The H-back is Lee Burggraf, Derek Hagan, one of the wideouts, Richardson the other, and Zach Miller is the tight end. This one out of the backfield, caught by Miller. And he is going to be down at the 28-yard line, a couple of yards short of the first down. Purdue's defensive unit. Up front, Spencer, Villarreal, Grover, and Edwards. The linebackers, Kegler, Hall, and the freshman, Cliff Averill. And the secondary, Paul Long, Kyle Smith, Bernard Pollard, and Brian Hickman.
The strength of the Purdue defense, really those guys up front, a very active, athletic defensive front line.
Third and two. Hand off up the middle. Close, got it.
See, this is a perfect situation for Dirk Koetter and their young quarterback, Sam Keller. He told us we've got to make hay on first and second down and try to come up in third and short or third and medium. That's the best chance we have, because this Purdue defense is very good when they get you in third and longer situations, do a lot of combination things with nickel and dime defenses. So that was perfect. First down, third down situation was third and two, and they could run for the first down.
That was Antone Salisbury who carried for the first down. Now Burgess is back in. Hand off, they'll keep it on the ground. Why not? Burgess up the middle. Bernard Pollard makes the tackle, number 31. Well, earlier this week, Hakeem Hill, who started the season as a third string running back, but then became the starter because of a suspension and an injury, was dismissed from the team. So it's been a fluid situation at tailback. Sam Keller, second series. Here's Rudy Burgess darting to his right. He gets a good block and he's loose. He is all the way out to the 40-yard line. Bernard Pollard with the tackle, but the third big gain for Rudy Burgess in the first quarter.
And this is all about vision, because this play starts here, and watch Burgess just cut it back. He sees everything collapse on the right side of the offensive line and does a nice job of seeing where an opening was and then using his speed to get
through. At a career high earlier this year of 186 and 34 carries against Stanford. Here's Keller with a play fake. Goes deep, got a man open. That one is caught at the 10-yard line by Derek Hagan, number 80.
The guy covering him, Paul Long, fell down, and that left Hagan wide open for Sam Keller to find him. I mean, it's tough enough when you got a guy who's caught 74 balls to cover him. You see the bootleg again, and Hagan right here, the defender falls down, and Hagan is wide open on the sideline. And Keller able to find him with the football.
Now, Derek Hagan, a junior for the season, as Todd said, 74 catches. And he gives, after that 21-yard reception, Arizona State with a first down and goal just inside the 10. Here's Salisbury down to the 5, perhaps the 4. See where they mark the football.
I think the key to this game so far and the big story of the game has been Arizona State's ability to run the football. This Purdue defense, number 2 in the Big Ten in stopping the run, just over 100 yards a game allowed. The only team in the conference that did a better job of stopping the run was the Iowa defense. And Arizona State right now with 73 yards rushing, and that has taken a lot of pressure off the sophomore quarterback, Keller.
One wide out, three tight ends. Burgess comes right. Gets 1 yard. It'll be third down and goal from the 3, 3.5. Brandon Villarreal and George Hall made the tackle then. Take a look at Roy Edwards.
I think the thing for Sam Keller right now is just to to stay calm. He's dropped the ball a couple times. One time it turned the ball over to Purdue. The other time the penalty with the blow to the head gave it back to them, and that's why they're still on this drive. For Sam Keller, it looks like they're going to call timeout before this third down play. He's just got to know when he's got to protect the football. He can't make a big play every play. Sometimes the defense wins.
Well, the ball spotted back at the five, just inside the five. So third and goal when we come back in a scoreless first quarter. Sold out Sun Bowl, 50,000 plus on hand. Arizona State and Purdue, 2:44 to go in the opening quarter. And the Sun Devils with a third and goal at the five-yard line. And they'll spread it out this time. Derek Hagan is wide right, two receivers off to the left.
I think the guy you want to pay attention to is this guy right here, Zach Miller, the tight end, number 86. The young freshman, Pac-10 freshman of the year, working in the middle. Here he goes, shifting to the other side of the formation now.
Keller, straight drop back, pressure, tipped, knocked down. Yeah. Defensive play by Keller, and again, it's Ray Edwards who has been unblocked.
Well, this time he was unblocked by design because they were trying to flip it out to Burgess, but Edwards just made an outstanding athletic play of using his 6'6" frame and getting up and knocking the pass down. See, they let Edwards go because they're trying to run a little slip screen, but Edwards gets his left hand on the ball, and Keller does a nice job of knocking it down, because if he doesn't get a hand on it, Edwards might come up with the interception.
Ainsworth missed from 50. This will be much shorter. This is a 22-yarder. Chad Christensen, number 10, is the holder. And Jason Burke is the snapper. The kick is up, and Arizona State is first on the boards. Second effective drive by the Sun Devils. This time they come up short on third and goal, but they tack three on the board. They have taken a first quarter lead over Purdue of 3-0. Jesse Ainsworth with that 22-yard field goal. Purdue, number 6 in the country, averaging 25.6 yards per kickoff return. It's Jerome Brooks and Gerard Void, the deep man. And this one will not be returned. Take a knee as Ainsworth plants it 5 yards into the end zone. Well, we mentioned Arizona State's 5-0 start. Purdue just brilliant out of the gates, but then had a four-game stretch.
Yeah, and that four-game stretch, they lost all four by a combined 10 points. And in the middle of that, they got their quarterback, Kyle Orton, hurt. I mean, he got his right hip hurt against Michigan. And then the following week, his left oblique muscle was torn and could not play in the Iowa game. And it was just really a difficult stretch, not only for Kyle Orton, but for the entire Purdue offense.
Came back and won against Ohio State and then plowed Indiana under. Here's a quick flip out of the left side to Dorian Bryant, number 9. He stays inbounds. And Orton out of the gun, blitz threatened by Arizona State. They are not blitzing. Orton with time down the middle, one hopper incomplete to Bryant, and Purdue will be forced to punt.
Again, third and 12 is tough against any solid defense. And you see a little discouragement by the Purdue offense going off the field. I think the next time they come on the field, though, they've got to come out throwing down the field. Not throwing side to side, throwing down the field, because I think they've got some matchups against this Arizona State secondary that they can take advantage of.
Dave Bright is on for the second time. He knocked one 50 yards the first time out. And Terry Richardson awaits the punt at the 33-yard line.
They've uncovered both of the gunners right now, trying to get after the punter here. They're all coming.
And they come. The punt is away, and it's another good one by Brightus.
In the area where
Richardson
the flag
backs
thrown.
Up, grabs yep. it at the 28, nailed.
Great punt.
Terrific effort by Dave Brightus. That's 54 yards yep. and nothing on the return. And so Sam Keller heads back on. Sam Keller, out of high school, made an oral commitment to the University of Michigan, a place where his father, Mike, was a three-time All-American defensive end back in the late 60s, early 70s, and changed his mind and at the last second decided to come to Arizona State. Here's the handoff to Burgess. Boy, has he had a big first quarter. Well, this is Preston Jones, beg your pardon. for the first carry. Preston Jones with a 10-yard gain, number 37. Another slightly built back with a very obvious physical resemblance to Rudy Burgess.
Help He's me, got a three in his jersey.
Help me climb out
he
of this
a three
hole.
In his number.
Okay. Oh, goodness. Well, we have reached the end of one, and it is a quarter dominated by the Sun Devils from Tempe, despite only a modest lead of three. That's the end of the first with our score, Arizona State 3, Purdue nothing. The Army Jumpers came out of that plane earlier. We'll return after this message and a word from our local station. From the 71st Sun Bowl in El Paso, Arizona State leading it. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, Tracy Wolfson on this gorgeous New Year's Eve afternoon. Second down and 10. Sam Keller with 5 of 10 in the first half. Flips a little screen out, catches Burgess right side, down at the 46-yard line as we get underway here in the second quarter. And Todd, impressions of the first quarter of play.
Well, I think the ability of Arizona State, number one, to run the football. They had 148 yards of total offense, 82 of it running the football. That's taken a lot of pressure off Sam Keller. I think he's settled down. He started 1 for 4. He's now 5 for 10 throwing the football. And then the speed of the Arizona State defense, I think, has surprised this prolific Purdue offense a little bit.
Keller back under pressure from Edwards. The pass left side, caught. And down the sidelines comes Derek Hagan.
And this was really a nice job of Sam Keller not panicking under pressure, because for a moment it looked like he might get sacked, and he was able to elude pressure long enough. Again, it's Ray Edwards who's putting the pressure on him. He's able to get away from Edwards and hang in there and find Hagan's on the crossing route. And then Hagan, who is excellent after the catch, shows a little burst and some strength and gets the first down.
Well, you see his career ranks. He's chasing records that are held by the great John Jefferson from back in the 70s. Here's a handoff and nothing doing on that one. JJ played in the mid-70s, then went on with the Chargers and Green Bay Packers. And Derek Hagan, with one more year, has a very good chance of erasing those records. And the field goal unit is on. We're going to try this from 52. So Ainsworth, who just missed, had length but was wide right at the opposite end, and there really is not a noticeable wind. So from 52, Jesse Ainsworth got the distance, missed it wide right.
Boy, and Cliff Averill, what a great effort by number 85, the outside linebacker. He jumped right up into the middle. I thought he was going to block it for a moment, and maybe he at least distracted the kicker Ainsworth. As it is, 3-0 Arizona State. The score stands.
50,000 plus on hand, a sellout crowd. First time ever in the history of the Sun Bowl. The blackout lifted. Local affiliate KDBC playing. Airing the game for the first time ever. So folks in El Paso getting to watch the game, those who couldn't get tickets. And here is the handoff to Brandon Jones, number 27. Not much there. Well, we have asked the
Aflac
trivia question of the week. The first quarterback to start 4 consecutive bowl games. And the answer is Johnny Roush of Georgia, 45, 46, 47 and 48. He played in the Oil Bowl, the Sugar Bowl, the Gator, and the Orange. And this year, David Green and Jason Campbell will join the group. David Green in Georgia, taking on Wisconsin. Jason Campbell in Auburn. Here's the pass. Right side caught, but not much of gain, if any.
Boy, oh boy, this Arizona State defense is impressive. I mean, now think about this. This is the Purdue offense, number one in the Big Ten in scoring, almost 33 points a game, number two in total offense, 455 yards a game, and right now they have less than 35 yards of total offense against this Arizona State defense.
Yet to convert a third down. They are 0 for 4 on third downs. It's 3rd and 5 here. Four-man front. Out to the near side, and they're not going to get this one either. as that catch is met by Ray Williams and tackled by Josh Golden, number 23, the junior.
Now the other thing to keep in mind, I mean, this is an Arizona State defense. We've talked about them playing without their quarterback, their offensive leader, Andrew Walter. They're arguably one of their best defensive players, Ricardo Stewart, number 7 on the sideline with a bad shoulder also. He's not playing in the ball game. And those are two key guys missing from the Arizona State equation, and the team has really picked up in their absence.
Ricardo Stewart recently named first team all Pac-10. Here's Brightus and Richardson. He'll back away from it. Oh, boy. Another great Purdue bounce.
Wow.
This one is the most effective yet. Wow. 58-yard punt. And nothing on the return.
Now, I wouldn't be surprised right here to see Arizona State, everybody probably expecting them to run a quarterback sneak or some safe play to get it out. Maybe to go play action and try to throw the ball deep out of their own territory.
Now, the guy who's running the ball marker on this side has been a little late. Trotting down there each time. He gets there. Safety.
Yeah.
One safety.
Close. I'm really surprised that they did that. I thought they would try to throw.
Brandon Villarreal got the tackle on Preston Jones. Number 55, junior from Allen, Texas, a suburb of Dallas.
Well, the defense slanted, and they guessed right. I mean, they were slanting to the side of the run. And Villarreal was not able to get cut off by the backside guard and made the play. If your offense can't score, then your defense scores. But it was set up by the tremendous punt by Dave Bright. Special teams and defense, Purdue on the board.
Let's go down to Tracy, who is with Coach Joe Tiller.
Thanks, Vern. Coach, your defense getting the job done, but how do you get this normally prolific offense going?
Well, they're playing faster and harder than we are, quite frankly. I think that we haven't set our feet to throw the football, and we're not executing our offense. Until we do that, things are not likely to change.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
You bet. Thank you.
All right, Tracy, thank you. Our score at halftime, 3-2. We'll be back with the Earthlink Halftime Report and Los Lonely Boys after these messages. And a word from your local station. It has been an intriguing first half with the baseball-like score of 3-2, a field goal and a safety, the only scoring in the first half of play. And a moment ago, Tracy Wolfson with Dirk Cutter. Trace?
Coach, are you happy with Sam Keller's performance so far?
Well, I wouldn't say we're thrilled. Sam's done a nice job of competing. Purdue's doing a good job of faking blitzes and then bringing overload blitzes, so they're giving us some problems. I'm real pleased with how our D's playing. Our D's playing great. We just got to finish drives on offense. Our team's playing hard. We're playing physical. We're playing fast. We got to finish up. We got to get points on the end of those drives.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck.
All right, Tracy, thank you. It is remarkable how dominant they've been, and yet the score, yeah, they lead by one.
Well, 259 yards, but only 3 points. A lot of that has to do their last several possessions. They started deep in their own territory, but I think he hit it. I think the story of this game so far has been the Arizona State defense, and maybe it's because Brent Guy, this is his last game. Those guys are playing inspired, but this defense is playing outstanding. They have really dominated the Purdue offense, and we know this is a very good and senior-laden Purdue offense.
Well, let's take a look at the halftime numbers presented by Pontiac. 3-2, first downs, overwhelming edge for Arizona State in every category. Rushing yards, passing yards, total yards.
That's just amazing. Kyle Orton in that first half, 7 of 15, 42 yards. So we'll get a chance to see what they went over in the locker room. Joe Tiller talked to Tracy on the way in saying we've just got to execute our game plan. And I think that's right, because I don't think Arizona State did anything really tricky in that first half. They just out-hustled them. They were faster and they were more aggressive than the Purdue offense.
Recall that Purdue won the toss at the beginning of the game. They elected to defer, so they will get the ball to open quarter number 3. Kyle Orton, very modest numbers in the first half. Well, Sam Keller's first half, number of tip balls, but he completed some passes as well.
Yeah, I think he managed things pretty well. I mean, he started off 1 of 4, and then he hit a couple big plays. He had the one fumble. Purdue didn't get any points out of it, but I thought he hung in there pretty well. And as the game progressed, I thought he got more comfortable. And I think Dirk Cutter got more comfortable with him. He threw the post pattern to Derek Hagan from deep in his own territory. And that suggests to me that the coach feels pretty comfortable with his young quarterback.
Well, his dad, Mike, former All-American at Michigan and a one-time third-round draft pick of the Cowboys, and his stepmother, Kimberly, they are among the 51,000 who are here today. Here's the kick, Ainsworth. My goodness. Nailed that, so it'll come out to the 20-yard line.
I think the other guy that maybe needs to get involved here for Purdue is their tight end, Charles Davis. 31 catches coming into the ball game, was a second-team All-Big Ten performer. Maybe another alternative. If so much attention being paid to Taylor Stubblefield, maybe somebody else needs to step up for this Purdue offense.
And Stubblefield with modest numbers, only two catches for 27 yards. This is a young man. Here's Orton back on first down. Looking deep, fires it deep, and he's got it in! Brian Hare, there's a flag down, a player down.
Orton's down. Orton got drilled as he threw the ball, but able to get it off, and a beautiful throw to Brian Hare.
Touchdown, Purdue.
Kyle Orton waited until the absolute last moment to throw this football. Take a look now. They go play action right away. They fake the run in here, and watch Kyle Orton. He's not going to know the hit's coming from the backside, but he holds it as long as he can and throws a perfect throw to Hare. The safety, Josh Barrett, took another angle underneath the play. Those hits hurt, but they don't hurt nearly as much when you get a touchdown on the other end.
Extra point is up and good. 80 yards for number 80. His third touchdown of the year on only 11 receptions. And just like that, Purdue gets his first lead in the ballgame. Longest touchdown pass in Sun Bowl history. 80 yards, first play of the third quarter. Kyle Orton to Brian Hare. And with one play, they get more yardage than they had in the entire first
amazing
30 minutes.
Joe Tiller must be some halftime speech giver, I'll tell you.
70 yards in the first half, 80 yards in that last play. And the kickoff from Ben Jones. Burgess and Richardson are deep, and Burgess will take a knee.
Let's go back and take a look at the touchdown. Here's where Brian Hare is right here. Now they are just going to run a post pattern, but the problem for Arizona State is he's going to get picked up by a safety, Josh Barrett, rather than a cornerback. So when they come out of the play action fake, it's man coverage with a safety on a wide receiver, and Brian Hare has excellent speed, and you see the safety, Barrett, took an angle underneath the ball, and that cost him the touchdown. If he takes a better angle, he probably still gets beat for the completion, but he doesn't give up a touchdown.
And a first down and 10, Arizona State, trailing by six. Second man through. That's Burgess again. He's out near the 35. He'll spot it at the 34-yard line. Boy, that must take the wind out of Arizona State's sails to give up a touchdown like that.
Well, and as well as their defense played, I mean, they really were dominant in that first half. And, you know, they kind of got surprised on that first play. And Purdue's pass offense is more of a sideline-to-sideline passing. They don't vertically stretch you as much. That was a vertical play, and they got right after him.
On second down, here's Keller. Flips it. Zach Miller threw his hands. Incomplete. So not having the kind of day that he envisioned. He is the Pac-10 Freshman of the Year, Zach Miller from suburban Phoenix, and his brother Brent is a redshirt freshman. Two are roommates, Brent also a tight end.
Yeah. Zach Miller was recruited by everybody. I mean, he took visits to Oklahoma, Miami, Tennessee, and chose to stay home, and primarily because of his brother. I mean, they're best friends, and they wanted to play together.
Here's Keller back. Got it, nice catch at the 45. That's another first down.
Good catch. Good job of Keller hanging in there and throwing under pressure, because there was pressure right up the gut on him, and he hung in there and made the throw. Hagan, another catch. Good solid hands. That's nice.
And Derek Hagan, we mentioned he might surpass all of the records posted by John Jefferson back in the 70s if he decides to come back for another year. 1,400 yard receiving games. First. Here's Keller. Got a man open, wide open. This is Moe Mutz, number 18, first down Arizona State at the 34-yard line. That's a gain of 25.
Just a four-man rush that time. Good protection. Mutz running the post corner. And he's open. Watch, it's just a four-man rush. It's going to be a nice pocket in here for Sam Keller. Not able to get to him. He's able to stay in there, find the matchup he wants, and then throw outside to Mutz. Now, do you know what Mutz's real name is?
No.
Henry. He disliked that name from the time he was very young, and he didn't want his brother and sister called him Moe and Mo, and it turned to Moe, and he goes by Moe, not Henry.
Here's Burgess. He goes by Rudy.
I'm going to finish that because he gets called Henry one time, and that's the first day of class when he goes in. The professor calls the roll and calls him Henry Mutz, and he goes right up and says it's Moe. Now, it's a one day every class, he gets called Henry.
Moe Mutz sounds like a comedian in the Catskills. So it's Moe.
It's Moe. Started as Moe.
Okay.
Became Moe. No Henry.
Now, you tell me the story about Moe Mutz. Do you know who started the wave? This is from the Department of Really Trivial Information.
I do not know.
Here's the handoff. And it's Salisbury down to the 20-yard line. At the University of Washington, a yell leader named Rob Weller, who later became the host of Entertainment Tonight, started the wave.
Wow.
I bet you didn't know you'd learn that coming to El Paso.
I didn't know that. I just knew when I played in Kansas City and we used to go to Seattle to play, that was where it was the worst,
yeah,
inside that King Dome. I didn't know it started up there, though.
Well, you can really dazzle your friends at back home in Canton when you get there. Reverse is fumbled. And Terry Richardson falls on it.
Tried to catch him with a little misdirection. They've got momentum. They're moving the football. Tried to get that Purdue defense running one way and come back the other way, and just a bad exchange between Burgess and Richardson. And Arizona State very fortunate to come up with the football, because a turnover there would have really been costly, as well as they've moved the football here.
That is a loss of 7. It's second down and 17. 9-3, the difference in the ball game. The first play of the third quarter, an 80-yard touchdown pass. Here's Keller with a play fake. Pulls it in. He's going deep for Hagan in the end zone.
Oh, my gosh.
Touchdown.
That's interference and a touchdown. I mean,
wow. 27-yard pass.
Boy, the thing you see about Hagan is his strength as a receiver. I mean, he is not the fastest guy, but very strong. Hard to knock off his routes. Hard to get the ball out of his hands. We've seen him hold on to the football after getting hit hard a couple times. And Sam Keller, very happy with his receiver on that one.
Remember Sam Keller telling us he was a little more fiery and emotional than Andrew Walter. And he finds Derek Hagan for a touchdown. We're tied with the extra point to come. Fine play by Derek Hagan on his 10th touchdown reception of the year. Now Ainsworth for the extra point to give ASU the lead. Got it. Minutes and 59 seconds to go, third quarter. Derek Hagan, 27 yards from Sam Keller. The heck with the flag. 10-9, Sun Devils. Back at the Sun Bowl, Mike Price, head coach at the University of Texas at El Paso. Well, if you believe in redemption, it's a wonderful story for Mike. Had the really terrible incident when he was the head coach at the University of Alabama. Was out of coaching for a year, never coached a game for the Crimson Tide, but Bob still hired him as the head coach here. They got to a bowl this year, and you can see the affection with which he's being treated as he walks out. Had a chance to chat with him last night. The two of us both spent time in our youth in Everett, Washington. I was teasing Mike. We still know the words to the Everett Seagull High School fight song.
I thought he was going to stand up and start singing it last night.
Well,
when he brought that up.
We were tempted. 51,000 plus. Just a great day and wonderful tribute to the way this city embraces this game to have this crowd here.
I think the burden is still on the Purdue offense here. I mean, they scored in one play. They still got to prove they could sustain something against this Arizona State defense. Meanwhile, Arizona State did what Dirk Cutter wanted them to do, finish a drive. We take a look at the touchdown play again. Here's Hagan up here. He's just going to run the post corner, and you're going to see the cornerback kind of turn outside expecting help from the safety. The safety got caught up a little bit looking at the play fake. And then it was one-on-one, Hagan on Petty, and just the strength of that receiver at the end of the play got Arizona State the touchdown. So they finally drove the football and cashed in with a touchdown.
Second down and five. Orton out of the spread. Stubblefield comes in, sets up in the slot. Here's the audible. And they rush three and drop eight, and the pass is incomplete. Intended for Ray Williams, a junior out of Scotch Plains, New Jersey, on the left side. Joe Tiller and Mike Price, great friends. Played against each other when Mike Price was the head coach at Washington State down here in 2001. Tiller, who was the head coach at Montana State before taking over at Purdue. Wyoming, I beg your pardon. I'm thinking about his playing days. Here comes the blitz. Orton reads it. Hot receiver left side. Down the sidelines and out of bounds. Gerard Void out of the backfield. Number 32, a gain of 17.
Yeah, this is really a good call by offensive coordinator Jim Chaney. Arizona State hasn't blitzed a lot, but the blitz is coming from this side, and they're going to free release the back on this side. So it's a hot read against the blitz. Nobody picks up that back, and it's a nice recognition by Kyle Orton and the first third down conversion for this Purdue offense. And they have struggled today on all downs, but particularly on third down. There's Jim Chaney.
Second down. Orton. And the ball is caught. And the tackle made by Emmanuel Franklin, number 13.
But again, the thing that Arizona State is doing well when they do blitz and they force the short throw, they're tackling well. I haven't seen many receivers for Purdue catch the ball, break a tackle, and then tack on extra yardage. When they have caught the ball, they usually go down pretty soon after they catch it. Good open field tackle by Emmanuel Franklin. Franklin was a cornerback in this defense for 3 years. He moved into the safety position this year, so he's not that uncomfortable being out in space covering a wide receiver.
Third and six. With a minute 15 to go, third quarter. Big play. Four-man rush by Arizona State. Orton across the middle, caught. And it's a first down, Purdue at the 37-yard line. As Brian Hare makes the grab.
Boy, Brian Hare did a nice job of, as soon as he caught that, turning straight upfield. If he would have backpedaled a little bit or tried to add too much yardage, he might have lost the first down. But he caught it. He knew he needed another yard or so for the first down, and he just quickly shot upfield and secured the first down.
Chains are set on the first down.
Go defense!
And Orton will go under center.
That's offsides.
Yep. Flags on either side. ASU penalty. Like you pointed out, Todd, those things mark.
Yeah.
They add up. And in increments. That's the eighth penalty. And it's first and five. Hare goes wide to the left. Play fake, Orton down the middle. Tight end Davis can't hang on.
Well, I knew it was just a matter of time before they tried to go to him. They got the situation they wanted, And it was a good throw by Kyle Orton, and Davis just not able to bring it in. We've seen both tight ends drop passes that they normally would make the play on. Zach Miller for Arizona State dropped one down the middle in the first half, and Charles Davis dropped that one.
Davis will report to Gene Katie's basketball team on Sunday and try and help turn things around for the Boilermaker basketball players, basketball team. Second down. Orton. No flag. Incomplete.
Again, just good job of reading and recognizing by the Arizona State defense. They know where Kyle Orton wants to go on some of the short routes. Whenever the pressure comes, they know what the blitz reads are and where the blitz throws are going. And the linebackers and corners are just kind of sitting on those routes. Dale Robinson that time didn't back up at all, just stayed right there. And made a collision right at the throw.
Third and five, 10-9, Arizona State. Purdue 3 of 4 in this half on third down conversions. Stubblefield wide left, Williams wide right. Orton out of the gun. Blitz. Orton got a man wide open, and he makes the grab.
Oh, my goodness, what a catch by Stubblefield. And Chad Green was the corner there, and he so much didn't want to get beat deep. I mean, it was a blitz. He knew he had Stubblefield man-to-man. The blitz, Orton throws it to the out, and just a tremendous catch on the sideline by Stubblefield. You see the right knee got down in bounds after the catch. I take that back. It was Mike Davis Jr. who was the corner in that time and really turned and ran to prevent getting beat deep.
And a first down and 10 at the 20. Orton down the middle and overthrows Dorian Bryant, number 9. Joe Tiller knows they should have had that one. Stubblefield with 312. Josh Davis from Marshall had 5 at the bowl game the other night. So he's got 306 for his career. Taylor Stubblefield out of Yakima, Washington, said it came down to a choice between Washington State or Purdue, and opted to leave home. On second down, handoff. Brandon Jones breaks the tackle, knocked out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Chad Green, number 21, was there, but missed him.
That was a big miss, too, because that would have brought up a third down and medium range yardage, and as it turns out, third and very short. We haven't seen Purdue have much success bouncing things outside against this defense, but Chad Green not able to wrap up Brandon Jones. Jones using his strength at 240 pounds to break that tackle and get to the outside. Now you could expect run or pass on third and short.
See Orton in the red zone this season. He has been brilliant. Third and short. Officially call it 2. It's now at the 10, and that should be enough to make it first and goal.
I mean, that graphic on the red zone, the most impressive things, 14 touchdowns and no interceptions. He knows how to protect the football when they're in scoring range.
We have reached the end of 3. 10-9 Arizona State with Purdue threatening. We'll return to Sun Bowl Stadium right after these messages. And a word from your local station. And the first play of the fourth quarter, they hurry and break the huddle.
Oh, boy.
And it's Bumbleroski. It sure was. Here's Dorian Bryant, and he's down to the 5-yard line. Fumble. Ruski, can you say Nebraska? Holy cow. Oh, terrific Joe Tiller. He's upset because it didn't work.
Yeah. Well, they gained a couple yards. I mean, it's just they hurried up to the line, so they obviously called it out of the huddle. Orton makes it look like he's got the ball. He's tackled by Jimmy Verdon. And really, pretty good job and pretty good discipline by the Arizona State defense. Orton fumbled the ball. It's picked up and advanced.
Oh, here's Orton back into the corner. Touchdown. There you go. Yep. Merry Christmas a week late. Yeah. Mr. Stubblefield. And they have reclaimed the lead. Quite a twosome in the history of Purdue football. 5-yard reception, his 16th of the year. And Ben Jones on for the extra point. Up and good.
Well, they went after Mike Davis Jr. He was the corner. Josh Golden is on the sidelines getting treated for cramps. They went right after the new corner. A lot of cushion and an easy touchdown for Taylor Stubblefield.
Purdue scores on the first play of the third quarter and the second play of the fourth quarter. They lead by 6.
Purdue ahead 16-10 as we take a look at the touchdown pass to Taylor Stubblefield. Here's the matchup out here. Stubblefield against a backup cornerback, Mike Davis Jr. Davis is in protecting the inside so hard that the little in fake by Stubblefield sent him even further inside, and that opened things up to the sideline. And that was just an easy throw and catch for two guys, Kyle Orton and Taylor Stubblefield, who just have such a great feel for one another. I mean, they've completed so many passes together on the practice field and games that they just know what the other guy is going to do. And that was too easy right there.
Purdue reclaims the lead. Kyle Orton in this half now 8 of 13, 143 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Ben Jones will kick off. Arizona State trailing by 6. And a good one for Jones.
You know.
Touchback. That one will come out to the 20. Play fake for Sam Keller. Goes left side. And there's Zach Miller, the freshman tight end. Leans out, and he is across the 50 to the 48. Zach Miller chatted with he and Sam Keller in Grayling Love yesterday. And Miller's a math whiz. Loves mathematical problems. He's a student of it. Sam Keller said, not for me. I'm a blue book kind of guy.
He likes history.
Yeah.
Kind of the way I was. I like history more than numbers.
I was, you know, the blue book thing was not bad. Here's second down. Keller. Did you ever take a calculus course?
Oh, yeah.
Did you then?
Yeah.
Man, I stayed so far away from that. I could have had a double major in history and sociology.
Well, I think you got a lot of good math students on the Purdue side.
Time. You know, bet.
Those engineering
bet.
Students.
Yes, indeed.
They better be pretty good in their mathematics.
There's the quarterback comparison for the day. And a third down now for Arizona State. 3rd and 5.
He went to Hagan on his last third down opportunity. He's at the top of the screen now.
Keller comes near side behind the intended receiver. It'll be 4th down, and Arizona State will have to give up the football. 4th and 5.
It's a good opportunity for Chris McDonald, who's only punted, I think, one other time so far today, to two times, I guess, to knock it down and try to give his defense a chance to play with Purdue's offense backed up in their own territory.
4th and 5. Again, low kick. This goes over the head and not quite. Just about. Stopped at the 1.
That's what you didn't want to do.
Right. 16-10, Purdue. They reclaim the lead on a pass from Kyle Orton to Taylor Stubblefield, and they've got a 1st down and 10 at the 20. This is Gerard Boyd for a couple. And Arizona State signaling, yes, there is a fumble. And the Sun Devils have it.
Wow.
A lot of wrestling around as the tackle was being made. And the Sun Devils come out with it.
Jimmy Verdon, one of the real leaders of this Arizona State defense. Coaches described him as just a rugged competitor, has never missed a day of practice or a game. And you see Boyd has stood up, and as he's fighting for extra yardage, the ball is ripped out. and Verdon comes away with it.
Well, that became a scrum.
Yep. Gabe Reiniger is the guy who held him up, and then the ball was ripped out of Void's hands, and Arizona State, after a poor execution of the punt, gets the ball right back on the 20-yard line.
Turnovers now even at one, and the ball at the 20-yard line. Here comes the blitz. Max blitz inside Reed. Keller knew it was coming.
He fumbled.
He fumbles.
No, they're calling it
incomplete.
Incomplete. That was close. I thought he had that football. I thought that Hagan, who is a very sure-handed receiver, had possession of that football, and I thought that was a fumble. And I think Joe Tiller did as well. Throw on the slant.
There's one.
No, no, he never really put it away, I guess, but he didn't argue too vehemently, did he?
No, not really. So a second down and 10. Hagan goes wide to the left side. Here's Keller. Steps up across the middle. Caught by his tight end, Zach Miller, to the 12-yard line. Might get it. Now they'll spot it at the 12.
Nice job by Keller, stepping up in the pocket, not panicking, finding an outlet receiver in his tight end, Zach Miller. And getting some of the yardage needed. Third and 3 is a lot better than third and 10.
Ball at the 12. Keep everybody in tight. That's Miller moving. Here's Keller. Sacked. Got him at the 16-yard line.
George Hall, the middle linebacker, came on the outside. He didn't come from the middle. He came outside and was unpicked up by the Arizona State offensive line. George Hall gets in there, and nobody picks him up. You see there's enough blockers in there for Arizona State, but the alignment by the Purdue defense fooled him on the blitz.
Now Jesse Ainsworth, who is 1 of 4, you see all 3 misses from 50 and beyond. This is to cut the lead in half, and he's done so. The Sun Devils get 3 out of the turnover, and it's a 16-13 ball game with 10 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the 71st Sun Bowl. 16-13, 10:33 to go in the fourth. First meeting ever between these two. 3-2 at the half. Arizona State with a field goal, and Purdue with the safety. Ainsworth to kick off. Brooks and Void of the deep man for the Boilermakers. This one, no. 20-yard line. 4-game stretch, beginning with a loss to Wisconsin by a total of 10 points.
Well, the loss to Wisconsin was devastating because it was at home. It was homecoming. They had a 17-7 lead with about 5.5 minutes left in the game and couldn't close the deal. And then a tough loss to Michigan, and then Orton was hurt. They played poorly at Northwestern, and Orton didn't even play against Iowa.
That one incomplete on the near side. Brian Hare can't hang on as McKenzie tips it away. It'll be second down and 10. Hare, who had the big play to open this half, an 80-yard touchdown reception from Kyle Orton. Second and 10. Williams, Hare go out wide right. Stubblefield comes to the near side. Empty backfield now for the Boilermakers. Arizona State has not blitzed all that much today. They will come this time, and Orton on the quarterback keeper is going to be caught and dropped at the 30-yard line.
Well, Gabe Reiniger has made some good plays ever since he came in. When Ishmael Thrower came out of the game, they moved Jimmy Verdon outside and they brought Gabe Reiniger in, number 95, and he has made a couple big time plays.
Dave Brightus has had a brilliant afternoon with an average of 50 yards on 6 kicks.
This may be his most important kick of the day right here. Needs to flip the field.
Not his best, but Rudy Burgess has taken the spot. Now, this is a good one. Absolutely. Notice that they've made the change. Terry Richardson had been back returning punts and had shown a distinct tendency to run away from the ball, so they put Burgess back there. Arizona State has it. They trail by 3. Made his way out of Las Vegas and got to El Paso. Probably returning tonight. 16-13, 7:52 to go. Sam Keller and the Sun Devils. Keller in his first start, right side. And this is Salisbury with the carry, number 41. Let's check out the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Total yards since the first quarter. Look how efficiently Purdue was held in check in the first quarter, but they've excelled since. 245 yards to 226 for Arizona State. Get complete game stats at CBSSportsline.com.
For Sam Keller and his first start, a pretty solid afternoon. 19 of 37, 230 yards and a touchdown. He has been sacked 3 times and he had a fumble, but game is in his hands right now.
And he's got Hagen over the middle. Hagen to the 40-yard line. A gain of 19.
Well, Derek Hagen has really shown himself well today. A big physical receiver. Good solid hands, good after the catch. And for the 4th game in a row and the 8th game of the 2004 season, Derek Hagen over 100 yards in receptions.
8 catches for 156 yards today. Look at the average, 19.5. And a first down at the 40-yard line. Down by 3. Richardson right side. Here's Keller looking Richardson's way. He's got Richardson in overthrow.
Boy, he sure had it.
Oh, dear.
They went a little out and up on Sean Petty, who is down with cramps again. Pretty good idea. You've got 3 cornerbacks for Purdue all battling cramps on the sideline. They went out and up. They had it beat. And Sam Keller, just not enough air under the ball on that one. It is a lot warmer than it's been here. I mean, they had snow the day before Christmas Eve and very cold temperatures over the holiday.
On 2nd and 10. Again, Purdue looks like they might be coming. Now they back away. And the games continue. Here they come. Sidearm behind Moe Mutz. It'll be 3rd and 10.
And Purdue has pretty much stuck to their plan the whole day, and that is to get after the quarterback. They line up and they stagger who's coming, so you don't know exactly which guys are blitzing, but be assured they are bringing pressure. They're going to try to bring more guys than you can block, and occasionally they'll throw some zone blitzes in there, but they've wanted to pressure Sam Keller, and I think for the most part he's held up pretty well against it.
3rd and 10, down by 3.
Here they come again.
Screen pass.
Oh,
they've got it set up. Yes, they do. Here's Burgess. Rudy Burgess, touchdown, Sun Devils. Zach Miller with a big block.
A screen play can be very effective versus a zone defense if everybody's dropping out of there, or a man-to-man if you block the guy that's responsible for the back. And that time, Arizona State executed it perfectly against the blitz.
Now the extra point from Ainsworth.
When you run a screen, you want the rush to come. If you're the quarterback, you're inviting the rush. Purdue is blitzing. 3rd down, they're going after the quarterback. You've got to get the guy blocked who's picking up the back. Arizona State did it, and Burgess turned it into a touchdown.
41-yard pass, Keller to Burgess. Sun Devils reclaim the lead. Rudy Burgess, tailback, converted to a running back. And let's take another look at that.
Well, the thing I want you to watch is right here. This is Brandon Villarreal right there at number 55, who's been excellent as a defensive lineman. Now, they're going to blitz, but it's his own blitz. He's going to drop back into coverage. Now, he's out of position. He's not used to playing in the middle of the field like that, and he can't get over and make the play on Rudy Burgess. It was just a well-timed call by Dirk Cutter to go with the screen pass against that blitz on third down.
Ainsworth to kick off. 6:23 to go. A four-point margin. This one will be returned. It's Jerome Brooks, number 22. And he gets back to the 19, perhaps the 20-yard line.
Kyle Orton needs to get hot again now. He's 17 and 34, but he's missed his last five. Game on the line now with 3:22 left.
And he avoids the pressure and finds a receiver over in the middle. Arizona State has recovered.
Was that void again? No, this time it was Brandon Jones who was in the backfield. A good hard hit on the football. Again, good coverage downfield to start the play. And Orton had to move out of the pocket. He finds his outlet, Brandon Jones. And just a good solid hit by Justin Virks, the middle linebacker. That knocked the ball loose, and Josh Barrett, the free safety, comes up with it. But again, these three linebackers playing against a passing team have been all over the field making plays.
Terrific hit by Justin Virks, and look how he celebrates. Oh, dear. One timeout left for Purdue. We've got 2:55 to go in the game. It's second down. And there's the tackle made by Anthony Spencer at the 49-yard line. And we'll see if Purdue uses their timeout. That's it. They are now out of timeouts. And it will be third down. No timeouts left. Third and 23. So Arizona State will keep it on the ground. That's going to bring up a fourth down now. And the clock will continue to unravel. It's at 2:37. Kyle Orton will get one last drive.
And what Dirk Cutter will do here is he'll just let this clock go down as far as he can. Maybe even run it all the way out, take a five-yard penalty, and then punt the football. Or they'll call a timeout right before the play clock runs out.
Dirk Cutter, Pocatello, Idaho, his hometown. Former assistant at University of Texas at El Paso back in the late 80s. Started his coaching career as the head coach of his high school, Highland High School in Pocatello. Head coach at Boise State before he got the job down here and has done a wonderful job at Arizona State. Fourth down.
Kyle Orton will get one more shot with the football. Again, he led them on a two-minute drive for a game-winning touchdown against Ohio State.
Back in the snap, blocked!
Wow!
Blocked! Blocked! And kicked over and out of bounds at the 35. Bernard Pollard got there. That's the eighth kick that's been blocked by Purdue this year. It was a low snap.
The eighth block kick, the third block punt. Boy, you always talk how important all three phases are. Protect the punter first and foremost. It's an all-out rush. They get in there and get it. It's Pollard, I believe, the free safety, number 31, who got his hand on the football. Low snap. That broke up the timing, and McDonald not able to get it out of there quickly because the snap was poor. And now Kyle Orton with no timeouts but a short field to try to get the win.
36 yards away. Snap back to Orton, four-man rush. Orton steps up. He's going to scramble. And he is down at the 26-yard line.
Just short of a first down, I think. And again, the pressure by Arizona State forces Kyle Orton to step up in the pocket.
eight kicks blocked this year by this Purdue bunch.
That ties the most under Joe Tiller. They had eight back in 1998, and they just tied that with that huge block punt by Ben Pollard.
Second and a foot. Orton delivers, Stubblefield to the six. Clock will stop while they reset the chains.
And again, a lot of time, a minute 30. They may spike the ball here, or they may go ahead and call the play, because that long gain, it'll take them a while to get the chain set. So they've got a lot of time to get something called. A minute 30, they're actually taking the time to get in the huddle.
And Dirk Cutter comes out and says, we need a timeout.
Big play by the big combination. They've been held in check for the most part, Orton to Stubblefield, but when the Purdue team needed it the most, they get a big one right there. This is where you want to pay attention also to Kyle Ingram. He's not been a factor in the game, but with 6'9" frame down around the red zone, somebody may want to look for.
Stubblefield wide right, Hare is wide left. Davis is the tight end. It's first and goal from the six. Quick setup inside.
Incomplete.
Incomplete. Second and goal.
Well, Stubblefield, the go-to guy. Josh Golden back in the game, and that wasn't ripped out. I think that one was just dropped by Stubblefield. A good throw on the slant. Taylor not able to secure the catch.
Same personnel, Stubblefield right, Hare left. Motion now from Keller. There's Orton going back into the end zone for Davis. He's got it. Purdue leads.
A well-conceived play, but an even better throw by Kyle Orton, because Charles Davis, normally when you call that play, he's running wide open. Charles Davis wasn't wide open. He was well covered on that play by Emmanuel Franklin, but it was a perfect throw to the big tight end.
Ben Jones for the extra point. Got it. Joe Tiller's team has reclaimed the lead with 1 minute and 14 seconds to go.
Let's go back and look at the touchdown. Charles Davis is going to get an acting award. Here he is right here. He's going to go and do the little flop right here. Lay on the ground and then pop back up and run to the other side. There he goes, down. Get back up. And usually this is wide open, but Arizona State was in position, but a perfect throw high and over the outside shoulder. And that enabled Charles Davis to use that big body and keep Emmanuel Franklin away from the football. Good call, even better execution by the senior quarterback, Kyle Orton.
Looks like it means a little bit to these kids. Charles Davis. I think Gene Katie will welcome him with open arms on Sunday.
Well, you know what? That was a perfect box out. That's all that was. He just boxed out Emmanuel Franklin and went and got the ball. And now let's flip the situation now for young Sam Keller, because this is still a good amount of time. If they get a decent return here, a minute 14, and unlike Purdue, Arizona State has two timeouts left. So Sam Keller has two timeouts to work the two-minute offense here. And the difference also is Arizona State does not need a touchdown like Purdue needed. They just need a field goal to tie the football game. A field goal could put this game into overtime.
1:14 remaining. Here's the kick from Ben Jones. Touchback.
Ainsworth has shown that he's got a strong leg, but he hasn't been very accurate today. 2 of 5 on field goal attempts. His makes were from 22 and 34.
Here's Keller back. Throws it left side and is caught.
Right there.
Get out of bounds. That stops the clock at the 23-yard line. The clock stopped with 67 seconds left. It'll be second down. See the red line, that's the probable need for a first down. Here's the pass left side. How about this? Richardson.
First pass is
out of bounds all the way to the 45-yard line.
Again, a lot of time for Sam Keller. 58.5 seconds, two timeouts. And again, you got these cornerbacks for Purdue that are still being bothered by cramps. Once you get behind in cramps, you can't really catch up. Sean Petty taking himself out of the game, and a big play by Terry Richardson for Arizona State.
58.5 left. Here's Keller. Looks deep for Hagan. Hagan's got it. Hagan's out of bounds. They stop the clock again at the 19-yard line. 26-yard gain.
I'll tell you what, you've got momentum right now. I don't know if your field goal kicker's 2 for 5 today, I don't know that you set up a field goal here. I think you try to go for a touchdown. Your quarterback feels good. He's thrown for over 300 yards. The cornerbacks for Purdue are taking themselves in and out of the game because of cramps. I say you keep the pedal to the metal here and try to score a touchdown with 50 seconds left. What Sam Keller can't do, though, is take a sack. He's got to get rid of the football if they get pressure.
Three wideouts, first and 10. At the 19, Max Blitz flips it out, caught by Burgess. Burgess cuts inside. Burgess, touchdown! How about Rudy Burgess?
Same play they scored on a little bit earlier. Blitz, flip the screen out. A guy unblocked. We might have a celebration penalty here.
There is a flag at the 1 yard line. I believe it's excessive celebration.
Which, I mean,
come on,
it's New Year's Eve, for goodness sakes. And you just took the lead with 43 seconds left.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Over two. Number 10.
Oh,
wow. He's ejected. Touchdown is good.
Wow. Ray Edwards. Well, I don't like to see that either, but I'm glad it wasn't a celebration with that kind of a play. Sam Keller, great poise on that play. You allow that rush to come in, and you flip the screen, and Burgess, who has just had a monster game. I mean, Sam Keller was the MVP, but Rudy Burgess, I don't think they could have won this game or had a chance to win without him.
Well, 125 yards rushing, and he's caught three passes for 64 yards. That is above average. So Edwards ejected. And the extra point coming.
You know, I was just watching the replay of that. The reason Edwards got ejected, he hit a referee. It wasn't a hit on a player. He bumped into an official on the sideline because he thought he was held on the play.
Here's the extra point, up and good.
Well, let's take a look. They went after it. I really like this idea. The blitz comes here. So Burgess is coming out here. He's the free receiver. Somebody in here has to pick him up, but nobody gets out there to get Burgess. You allow the blitz to come. You flip it over the head of the outside rusher, and then you execute down the field. Now, at the end of the play, here's Edwards right here. And he bumped into the official, and that's where the penalty came and the ultimate ejection. He thought he was held on the play. I don't think he tried to bump into the official. But nonetheless, an excellent call and really good execution. Under heat, Sam Keller flips it out. And Burgess does the rest. And we saw that play earlier in the game. They tried to run it, and it was tipped by that outside rusher. And,
right.
And you could see Sam Keller, he's growing in this game. A little more loft on that one, and it ends up being a touchdown.
Yes.
We didn't know it was going to end up this exciting, did we?
No.
This has been some second half. Goodness gracious.
Here's the kick. Oh, boy. That one's going to Juarez.
He got to kick it from the 50, and he made the most of it.
So 43 seconds to go. Purdue comes back on from the 20-yard line, trailing by four. What did we say at the beginning? The air might be filled with footballs. Here's Orton on first down. Across the middle, incomplete. Second down. I don't know what about that previous picture reminded me that it is the Vitalis symbol. Second and 10.
I get it now.
Okay.
I didn't get it at first.
You were a little slave. You're still thinking about the Aflac trivia question. Here's Orton back on second down. This one, incomplete, third down.
It's probably a good thing for Taylor Stubblefield that was incomplete, because with no timeouts, it was not enough for a first down and the clock would have continued to run. Low throw, and ball clearly hits the ground. Good call by the officials, and probably actually a break for Purdue that it was incomplete.
Third and 10. They'll stunt again. Fourth down, pass incomplete. Fourth and 10. With 31 seconds to go. Well, this could be it for this marvelous tandem of Kyle Orton and Taylor Stubblefield. Fourth and 10, down by four, 31 seconds remaining. There's my Vitalis guy. Fourth and 10. Left side. Caught out of bounds, and that is a first down. 26 seconds to go.
Again, Purdue needs a touchdown. Very difficult situation. 26 seconds, no timeouts. Arizona State is going to play deep with their four deep zone and try to keep everything in front of them and force an underneath throw.
Orton with time this time. Across the middle. Almost intercepted. Incomplete. Dorian Bryant and Justin Burks got there. 21 seconds to go.
Kyle Orton, he knows they're playing deep zone, trying to drop it off to a guy who can run pretty well after the catch. The problem for Dorian Bryant, got to catch it first before you can run.
Ray Williams goes wide right. Stubblefield, bottom of the screen. Second and 10. Orton goes deep right side. It's caught. And Bryant cannot get out of bounds. And the clock now 12 seconds.
Well, and they're going to stop it to measure, but he almost lost the first down. He had the first down when he first made the catch, and that would have stopped the clock until they checked the chains. But he tried to go out of bounds, and he actually gave up some yards. It is a first down, so the clock stops until they move the chains, but Purdue has to be ready to go right now.
11.4 to go. And now, a huddle with the officials.
On the game clock, 15 seconds.
So we will reset the game clock. It has now been done. Orton, right side, incomplete. 10 seconds to go. ...27-23... Arizona State. Second down and 10. Almost at Big Ben time. Right side. Caught out of bounds at the 47-yard line. 6 seconds to go.
Yeah, now we're at Big Ben time.
Yep.
I think they wanted to get across the 50 just so that they could ensure that Kyle Orton could get the ball to the end zone with the last throw. That's why the last two plays they've gone with a little short route to try to get it in range to throw one to the end zone.
So Williams goes wide right, Stubblefield and Hare wide to the right.
And I got to believe, we've not gotten a report, but I got to believe that Kyle Ingram got hurt at some point, because with it being a 6'9 receiver, you'd think he'd be in the game in this situation.
Final play of the game. Here's Orton toward the end zone, up, tipped, incomplete. Game is over. Arizona State has come from behind in a seesaw battle. Sun Devils win it, 27-23.
That was a fun football game, I'll tell you. Great comeback by both teams. Sam Keller in his first start. Outstanding game.
Our final game of the season. It was a doozy, was it not? For Tracy Wolfson and Todd Blackledge, I'm Vern Lundquist. Happy New Year, everybody.